Indeed back, and we had a few technical difficulties along the way, but we actually managed to get everything set up, so there was a little bit of a
sorry
time
for
lag there.
The
sorry about
five
that.
Six minutes delay,
seven
guys
minutes. 7 minutes to be exact.
7 minutes to be exact. Well, this is live, you know, that's gonna happen at
some
point.
Yeah, we don't want anyone to correct us on the time schedule. So thank you very much, guys, for coming back on Twitch, and also thank you very much for coming back here at the Tokyo Otaku Mode live stream hut booth here in Tokyo Game Show 2016. Now, we just had a very soothing and also in-game, very deep conversation with the guys from Tokyo RPG Factory. We actually had a good look at what I Am Setsuna, which is Ikeniya to Yuki no Setsuna, the Japanese title, now already localized and out, available for you guys to purchase. I Am Setsuna, it was a very beautiful game. We also had a little bit of a collaborative effort going on with us, Tokyo Otaku Mode, and Tokyo RPG Factory with a paper music box.
Yep.
Yeah, which is that also available on our store.
That looks absolutely gorgeous. I mean,
and now we're going to make a huge transition from a deep,
like I
snow
said before,
RPG game to something more contemporary, something in the realms of Akihabara. So we're going to go and take a look at Acquire's new upcoming game, Akiba's Beat.
All right.
So let's go ahead and get our guests on stage. Please welcome Acquire. Thank you very much for coming on stage. Kyo, yoroshiku onegai itashimasu.
Yoroshiku onegai itashimasu.
Now, this is a game that comes into serialization with the prior Akiba strip. And this is going to be a new game, and we were going to want to hear a lot about it. Now, first of all, we're going to go ahead and start off with an introduction from our guests. Please go ahead. Take it away.
本日、東京オタクモード、東京オタクモードライブストリームハットにお越しになってありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いいたします。ゲームの紹介に始まる前に、自己紹介を簡単に。
はい。
よろしくお願いいたします。
はい。アクアヤから来ました、プロデューサー、田村純一郎です。皆さんよろしくお願いします。
Hi everyone, I am Junichiro Tamura, the producer of Akiba's Beat from Acquire.
Hi, Acquire から来ました、director の高野Kota です。よろしくお願いします。
Hi, I am Kota Takano, the director of the game.
Thank you very much, and welcome, welcome indeed. Now, for those of you who are already immersed in the streets of Akihabara and Akiba's Strip, and also this time Akiba's Beat, we're going to go ahead and talk about why the choice. Why Akihabara?
Yeah, まあ、まず一つ目の質問としては、はい、なぜ秋葉原をテーマとしてゲームにしましたのでしょうか。
あ、はい、そうですね。アクアイアという会社は、秋葉原のもう駅の前すぐそばにありまして、毎日がその秋葉原の街を見てみんな仕事をしてるんですね。でそんな、会社の環境ある中で、やはりゲームを作るのであれば秋葉原を舞台にしたゲームを作ることで、皆さん、ゲームプレイヤーの皆さんが楽しんでもらえるのではないか、より秋葉原に詳しい会社として、ゲームを作っていけるのではないかというふうに考えて、今回作っています。
Well, the reason is pretty simple, because our offices are situated just a few minutes away from the main station of Akihabara. We just walk out of the station and there we are. So we're practically living there, or all of us. We're working and coming every day. And I don't think there is a game company in this country that is more familiar with Akihabara than us.
Well, I mean, you are down center in Akihabara, so you know, there's no real reason why you wouldn't make a game about Akihabara.
And so, yeah, after a long time, when we were thinking of new ideas to make a game, it came pretty naturally that we could use the actual setting of our daily lives, which is the city of Akihabara, to immerse the player into our daily surroundings.
Absolutely. Now, before we go into the actual new game here, we want to talk a little bit about Akiba's Trip. Now, the concept of this, as far as I can remember from actually playing the game, is that you're supposed to take off the clothes from the enemy characters because they are vampires that are not really good at against light. So you have to kind of rip off the clothes from your enemies. And that's part of the game mechanic. This time in Akiba's D, is it going to be as zany as the last two prequels?
Akiba's Strip では敵を倒すには、はい、服を 脱がすように、はい、あの設定はあの吸血鬼ヴァンパイアだったの であの太陽の光に弱いのでそうそうそう服を外してもらえればあの敵を倒せるっていう設定だったんですけど、はい
そうですね、
アキバズビーとは同じようなあの非常に面白い設定もあるのでしょうか
そうですね、やはりあのアキバズトリップというのは皆さん印象に残っているの で今回のアキバズビートでもっていうふうにちょっと考えられるかもしれません、その意味で言うと残念ながら、脱がすという、行為はありません、今回はその秋葉原をその舞台にそのなんですかね秋葉原ならではの要素っていうところ、秋葉であればトレーディングカードを集めるであったりとかアイドルのコンサートアイドルの CD を売っていたりとかっていったところそういった、カードを、スキルに置き換えてみたり、CD ソングを、バトル中の BGM に使うっていったふうに秋葉原を取り入れています。
なるほど。 No, I'm very happy that you remember and that Akiba's trip left you such a strong impression.
Oh, it sure did. It definitely did.
But in this case, in case of Akiba's beat, the setting is really focused on the city itself. I would say the main protagonist is Akihabara. So what you want to do is to, you are going to collect cards, for example, trading cards, or go to idol concerts. These are the things you do in actual Akihabara. So this is what you're going to do in the game. And so the trading cards you collect are going to be battle items. And the CDs, the idol CDs that you buy are going to be your battle BGM. So this is how the game is going to play out.
So you can expect much more immersion in the actual city of Akihabara and Akihabara's beat. So one of the things that I wanted to ask is that this is not going to be a sequel. More like a standalone. It does bear the Akiba's name, but it's going to be more of a standalone game on its own.
ですが、あの、アキバズトリップとアキバズビットのアキバの部分があるのですが、あの、それは続編のではなく、またあの完全に新しい同じあの新しいオリジナルのタイトルということをとの理解で大丈夫。
そうですね、同じ秋葉原を舞台にしてはいますけど、世界観っていうのは別のものです。ただそのいずれのゲームでも秋葉原っていうのは常に人の思いであったりとかいろいろなエネルギーっていうのが詰まった街として舞台にしています。
Yes, yes, it does bear the name of Akihabara, but as a game it will be a completely new and original title, but it does bear the atmosphere of Akihabara, memories and the soul of all the people who are living and working in the city. So it does, as you said, play on immersion in the city of Akihabara.
Fantastic. And just how much time do you guys actually spend investigating Akihabara? Because even in the previous Akiba Strip and Akiba Strip 2, there was a huge amount of detail going into building a virtual version of Akihabara. So I want to just out of interest want to hear how long did it take to integrate everything into the game from the actual real streets of Akihabara.
と前作をプレイした時には、はい、あの非常に秋葉原のあのそこら中のすごい細かい詳細をたくさん入れてまさに秋葉原を旅しているような感じだったんですが、
はい、
一番聞きたいのが、はい、あの秋葉原の街自体を、はい、取材とかそういうあの探索をするのはどれぐらいの時間をかかったのでしょうか。
あ、実際に作るにあたって、どのくらい取材をしたかということですね。
そうそうそう、はい、あの街に出て取材に行くみたいな。
はい、そうですね、あの秋葉原トリップですで、に1回街は作ってはいたのですけど、うん、それもすでに2年3年以上前の話で、だいぶかなり秋葉原の街並みは変わってしまいました。
変わりますね、
はい、ですので改めてまた一から、いろいろな細かい路地の方から、まあ、当然表通りも変わってますけどいろいろなところを、スタッフが写真を撮ったりとか実際に見に行って、今回ゲームの中に反映しています。
Yes, we actually recreated the whole city already in Akiba Strip. So we had a base, but that was already 3 years old. And if you are familiar with Akihabara, you know that the city changes really fast. It is true. It changes all the time. And so we had to restart from scratch.
have our team prepare the cameras and take pictures everywhere and recreate the city again from scratch, from zero.
So this is a complete overhaul. You started off from the beginning, build it up again, and now we actually have Akihabara Beats, more immersive Akihabaras.
Exactly.
Is there? That's fantastic. Well, I'm pretty sure you guys really want to see how this plays out, so we're going to go ahead and go into the gameplay, if that's all right. Actually, if we can probably take a look at the animation here as well for the intro right here as well, if we could, that would be fantastic too.
まあ、多分皆さん期待してると思うんですけど、
はい、
そろそろゲームプレイに
行、ね、
きましょうかと思って、
はい、
その前にちょっとだけ、はい、このイントロムービーをちょっと見せたいと思ってて、
はい、
アニメーション、そのアニメーションについて少し教えていただけるのでしょうか。
なるほど、了解です。今はまだ画面映ってないですね。
はい、そうですね、そろそろ映ってます。
オープニングアニメとして、はい、今回、キャラクターたちがアクションするオープニング画面を作りました。はい、今見てもらっているようにゲームの中に出てくるキャラクターたちが、音楽を舞台にいろいろアクションしてくれます。曲は、以前のアキバズトリップでも使っていたクラリスさん、グループのクラリスさんの曲を、使わせてもらってます。
So, this is the intro movie for the game that will present to you the cast of the game, the different characters and in different situations. And just as in Akiba's trip, we are using the music from the group called Claris.
Claris, of course. As done in Akiba's trip. All right, so we should go ahead and go into the gameplay.
Let's start. Yes,
let's start. It's
going to be very exciting.
Takano-san, please.
Thank you very much.
So just to introduce ourselves to the game again, what is going to be the main system here? What is going to be, how is the game going to be laid out as an RPG?
So, 先ほど少しゲームについてカードと CD の話をしましたんですが、
はい、
もうちょっと詳しくゲームのシステムとかゲーム自体の紹介をお願いいたします。
はい。はい、今回、アキバズビートはロールプレインゲームとして、リリースしています。しかもその戦闘はリアルタイムのアクションで、敵を倒すというものですね。前回 の, そのアキバーズトリップに比べてあちらはアドベンチャー、アクションアドベンチャーでしたが、今回アクション RPG です。はい、今ちょっと秋葉原の駅前でいます。
来ました、すごい。
はい、
I'm sorry, I personally have spent hours and hours and hours in Akihabara. This is one of my favorite places, and I knew in one second I knew where I was.
Yeah,
this is
yeah.
incredible. Like, this is the exit from the left when you get out of the JR station.
Yeah, this is literally Akihabara.
This is literally Akihabara. Like, this is really impressive for me. Like, I really felt I was there for a second. Yeah, so let me come back to the question from Gin-chan. Akiba's Beats is a role-playing game that will feature actually real-time battles.
All right, then. So this is going to play out as an RPG.
Yes.
All right, cool.
So now we have...
So do we have a bit of a backstory of the actual game itself?
ちょっとバックグラウンドのそのストーリーについて少し説明をお願いします。
なるほど、はい。主人公はこの、左にいる橘朝日という少年です。彼は、実はニートで、普段働いてもいないし、学校にも行っていないというキャラクターなんですね。はい。で彼がある日、秋葉原の異変に巻き込まれて、さまざまな、謎を解いていくというものなんですけど、
はい、
今ここ秋葉原の駅前です。彼は普段ニートなので、楽に過ごしていきたい、毎日こんなだったらいいなみたいな、そういった思いを、して暮らしていたんですね。
Yes, so to give you a little bit of the backstory, so the hero that you can see wearing his white jackethe's what we call in Japan NEET, N-E-E-T, which means he's not employed nor is he in school.
Yeah,
he's,
that's right, yeah.
He's just a lazy.
Just a loafer.
Just a loafer, lazy dude, hanging out his apartment every day. And so one day he will, as he's strolling through the city of Akihabara, he gets involved in some weird incident. And I won't go further in details that you will understand more as you play.
So now this is actually looking more of a sort of a sandbox look to it. And also your point of view kind of is not a bird eye view. In fact, you're actually looking right behind him. So you do get a huge amount of depth into the streets of Akihabara. And of course, I should mention that Akihabara Street is not this dispersed. there's much more people here in real life.
こんな風に見えて人が実は、はい、本物の秋葉原より少ないですよね。
なるほど、そこはちょっと、厳しい視点かもしれません、土曜日、日曜日の秋葉原に比べるとちょっと少ないかもしれませんけど、そうですね、平日の夕方とかぐらいだったらこのぐらいの人はいるかもしれません。なかなか痛いところ、厳しいところを言われてしまいました。でも頑張って人はたくさん出しますよ。
なるほど。Actually, oh, oh.Is that so little people? Yeah, it's true. It's true that Akihabara on Saturday, Sunday, it gets a lot more crowded than you can see. But on a regular weekday, you know, after hours, that's about what you can see. But I will take the criticism and we'll try to add more people, a bigger crowd in the game.
Well, I wouldn't want to actually have a game where I have to bump into people to get to my destination at all times. So I think this is absolutely perfect.
バランスは多分ちょうどいい。これぐらい多すぎるとずっとぶつかりながらやるにもゲームも困るので。
そうですね。本当にリアルにたくさんいると目的の場所に行くにも大変苦労すると思いますので。はい。
So now there's a transition of actual time inside the game. Is this going to be real? Is this going to be three different types? Like we're going to have daytime and nighttime, or do we have different transitions as well?
ゲームの画面のご覧の通りに時間が進んで、はい、今夕方にもなっているの で、はい、そのゲーム上 の、 その時間の進み方について説明をお願いします。
はい、前作のアキバズトリップではずっとお昼だったんですけど、昼間だったんですが、今回アキバズビートでは、昼間、それから今の夕方、それから夜、少し暗くなってもライトがたくさんイルミネーションがついているのと、さらに深夜っていうのを4つ用意してます。ただ彼はニートなのでいつも行動するのはお昼からなので朝はないんですね。
なるほど、いやそれいいですね。That's pretty good comment there. Actually, contrary to Akiba's trip that was always during the day, Akiba's beat will feature like the time passing. You will be playing at first from noonThen go in the afternoon and the evening, right, when all the lights come up. And then, of course, there's the middle of the night where the store closes and the streets go dark. But as your character is a good for nothing, lazy loafer, he always sleeps in the morning. So there is no morning in Akiba's beat. It always starts, the day starts in the afternoon.
That makes totally sense. Is there going to be different things that you can actually do in different times of day?
その時間によって、はい、できるアクションとかがそれ、それぞれこう変わるとかそういうことはありんですか？
そうですね、当然昼でないと開いてないお店であったりとか、夜になると開くお店、少しずつそういった時間によってできることっていうのはプレイヤーに変わってくる、違ってくると思いますね。はい。
Yes, of course, just like in real life, there are some places that are closed during the day and only opens in the evening. And of course, some stores that you can go during the day that will be closed during the evening, so it will give the player objectives that would depend on the hour of the day. For you to take action.
So I'm pretty sure there'll be some backtracking and going back and forth between different days, times of day.
Mm-hmm. You have to mind the time, just like in real life.
Yeah, fantastic. So at what point of the game are we right now?
今はゲーム、そのストーリーとかの、どのぐらいのところに進んでるのですか？
これは今本当に一番最初のところですね。
なるほど。
本当にまだ彼主人公の朝日は普段と変わらない日常を過ごしているっていうことです。はい。で今1日経った状態なんですけどね。
Yeah, so no, this is really the beginning of the game. We haven't started the main event in the story yet. This is still the premises where the main character is just strolling around Akiba's every day without much purpose.You've seen the first day is already gone, so now we're attacking the second day.
So it's going to be the second day.
Exactly.
I see. Whoa, whoa, what's going on over here?
画面の方見てもらうと思うんですけど、これが今まで普段の秋葉原だったはずなんですけど、駅前がこんな風にちょっとスピーカーがたくさん出てきていて、何か違ったことが起きている、そういう状態になって彼の非日常が始まるわけなんですね。
All right, so this is starting. As you can see, that those weird speakers have appeared.
Is this where the beat drops?
ここで Akiba's beat ですね、スピーカー。
そうですね。まず最初はそういったビート、音楽に関係した。これは実は、秋葉原にいる人たちの誰かの妄想によって生まれた異次元、異元、異次元、なんて言ったらいい、不思議な現象です。は
い。Yes, so, without revealing too much, yes, of course, the beat...in the title it is related to music and this phenomenon that you can see、is related to somebody's imagination、in Akihabara who's creating these illusions.
So someone's imagination is interfering into the real world, right?
Exactly.
I like how this premise is going.
All right.
こちらの右にいるオレンジの髪の女の子、これが2人目に出てくる合流する星野咲という女の子です。彼女がいろいろと実は、この不思議についてちょっと知っていることがあって、この朝日に対していろいろと、巻き込んでいこうとしている状態で、
助っ人ですね、
助っ人、そうですね、一緒の、チームを組んで、秋葉原を救おうとしています。
なるほど。 So the girl you can see on the right wearing orange clothes is called、Aki Hoshino and、she's, she knows stuff.
She
it
knows
seems
stuff.
That she knows, no, she knows what's going on with those mysteriousappearances、
oh,
in, the,
okay.
in the city,
so she
and
plays
so
into the story
she will
as well.
Become your first ally in Akihabara.、
So she's one of the protagonists as well.
Yes.
All right, cool.
そして先ほどの、スピーカーのおかしなオブジェクトの隣にこういった扉が出てきます。Oh. こちらは、実は、妄想で生まれた妄想宮というダンジョンを入り口になっているんですね。
なるほど。
そして彼は入っていきました。こんな風に今までの、
oh, 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 now
he's got a sword. 秋葉原とは異なるスピーカー音響の、をイメージしたダンジョンが発生しているわけですね。
なるほど。So as you can see,、close to those weird speakers appearing at the station, there was this door.、the door is the、opening to、the dungeon that we、like to call the,、the imagination maze,、which is born from the imagination of the main antagonist.
So this is where the combat is going to be. I love the stylizations here. It's basically looking like an,、sort of an amp. And so we got amps、
yeah.
in the background.
We have the, we have the wave of the
we
sound.
We have the wavelengths.
Oh, oh,
yeah,
we have wavelengths.
Well, that's fantastic.
And the beats.Beating around.
はい、というところで今、どんどんとダンジョンの奥に進むにつれて
このそろそろ
さっきの
バトルに入る、はい、バトルにということですか、
ね、はい、バトルに入ります。
Encounter! There he comes! Perfect timing again!
最初の敵ですからそれほど強くない可愛い敵ですね。まあ、すぐにこれ倒してしまいます。まあ、
最初のところなのでまだ
本当に最初の部分です。
まだ始まったところなので。
So the weapons、unique to each character in this game?
武器はキャラクターごとは変わりますか、それともみんな同じ使える武器が変わったりとかするのでしょうか。
そうですね、武器についてはキャラクターそれぞれ、特有のものです。
特有なものが、
はいはい、例えば朝日あ主人公朝日は、長剣ロングソードですし、サキは、ショートソードのツインダブル、
なるほど、
縦持ちです
ね、yes.
二刀流ですね。
So、the weapons as you were asking are、definitely linked to the characters. They all have affinities to different types of weapons. The main character Asahi is、better using long swords, whereas Aki、Saki, sorry, the female character, she likes using、double short swords.
Sweet.
All right.
こうしてどんどんダンジョンの奥に進んでいきます。
And we make our progress through the dungeon.
敵とのエンカウントはシンボルエンカウントなので、フィールド上にいる敵に、接触することで戦いが始まりますし、それを避けていけば戦闘しないでどんどん奥に進むこともできます。
As you can see, the enemies appear on the map, so you can choose to engage combat or you can decide not to and try to avoid the enemies. This is your choice.
I see a little counter on the、edge of the、hit point bar. I wonder what that is.
ゲーム中はキャラクターを切り替えることができます。もともと朝日でプレイしてましたけど、今彼は途中で先にキャラクターをチェンジして。
なるほど。さっきのところにカウンターがこう3、2、1でこうちょっと。 あの減ってるところを見られて、それがどういう意味なんでしょう
か。基本的には、こちらの今4-3-2-1-0となったのは、これは一度に行動できるアクション、ポイントですね。はい、で、ゼロになったら一定の時間で回復します。
なるほど、はい、So the counter is the number of actions you can performwhen you reach zero, you have to make a short break before you're able to regain your points and make more actions.
Nice, nice. I didn't even notice that.
So it has a little tactical element where you have to pace yourself.
Very useful, especially in combat.
ちょっと強そうな敵を敵に。
Oh, here comes a bigger baddie. The one that looks a little stronger.
So at this point, we're just seeing regular combo attacks. Is there going to be like a special move for each character at some point?
今のところはまあ普通のコンボを見られてるんですけど、はい、これからなんか特別必殺技とか、はい、そういったものとかってありますか？
そうですね、まだ冒頭ゲーム始まったばかりなので彼らはスキルを持っていませんけど、ゲームを進めていくに従ってより強い派手な、攻撃というのができるようになります。
Yes, of course, you can expect, as this is the beginning of the game, of course, the characters are still very new to battle, but as they gain experience, they will unlock more skills, and with more skills, get more incredible moves that they can use.
So like a contemporary RPG, there is an element of leveling up and also acquiring new skills that you can use during combat.
RPG ですから、やっぱりレベルアップと新しいスキルと新しいアイテムをだんだんこう使うようになるということですね。
そうですね。先ほどの言った、トレーディングカードを集めることで、スキルを、キャラクターたちは身につけることができたりもします。
なるほど。Yes, as I said earlier in the interview, the trading cards that I mentioned will unlock new skills for you to use in battle.
So that's where it comes into.
Exactly.
I see, I see. This is all intertwining too nicely.
で、今ちょっと、先の方に進みまして、より強い敵、またそれから彼ら主人公たちも派手なスキル技が使えるように今進めていますので、ちょっと待ってみてください。
Okay then.
So we're switching to a different save in the game, so we can show a little more skills, a little more variation. This is a little further down the story.
Okay.So we get to see some special moves as well.
We might get to see some special moves as well.
はい。ちょっとすみません。セッティングもう一回ちょっと一回オフしてもらえます。裏の画面が出ちゃいます。ごめんなさい。
All right, sure, sure, no problem.
Sorry, guys. We're gonna need to do some adjustments here. So
yeah, don't worry. We're gonna just talk about a few things as well.
Actually, there was a question on the chat that might be interesting to know.
Oh, please.
Right there. Let me get your name straight, Mr.Cult of Vengeance, Mr. Cult of Vengeance or Miss Cult of Vengeance was asking, will there be references to Divine Gate since Akira's Beat has the same artist?、Mm. Divine Gate, is it the same in Japanese?
Yeah, Divine Gate, yeah.
デバインゲートってご存知ですか、
はい、当然我々が作ってるタイトルです。
そうです、そうですね。チャットでは、はい、デバインゲートのちょっとそういうなんかキャメオとかイースターエッグ的な同じアーティストが作っているようなので、あそういったところがありますか。ちょっと隠れたアイテムとか。
鋭いですね、そもそもこのキャラクターのデザイナーは、ディバインゲートのデザイナーと同じ人ですし、また、今回来ております高野はディバインゲートの、ディレクターでありました。実際のところその何でしょう、細かなところっていうのはまた実際にゲームを見てから言っていただきたいですけど、やはりそのディバインゲートのファンの皆さんにもキャラクターに馴染んでいただけるような、デザインをしてはいると思いますよ。はい。
Yeah, I'm very impressed that you actually are so knowledgeable about our titles. That warms my heart. Yes, so the as you were mentioning, this is the same character designer as the Divine Gate, and we have tried to make it.So that the new characters, you get to love the new characters as much as you loved the characters from Divine Gates, and who knows, maybe there will be some references.
Yeah, shout out to our boy Cult of Vengeance.
Cult of Vengeance, that was a really great question.
Yeah.
Thank you
so much.
So
there might be a few nods here and there to Divine Gates. That would be fantastic. Now, I wanted to go back to this concept of having to go through Akihabara, because I know you guys work from scratch again.To actually make the immersive world of Akihabara inside the game. I was wondering if you guys have any that episodes that just come out from the bat, like something interesting that happened while you're investigating in Akihabara.
あの秋葉原の街を再現するには、はい、先ほどあの、はい、取材の話をしてたんですけど、はい、取材しながら何か面白いエピソードとかありましたか？
あ、そうですね、さっきも言ったように秋葉原というのは非常に入れ替わりがあるということで、秋葉原トリップからビートに来るにあたって取材をしました。でも、秋葉原ビートを作ってる時も、先夏頃なんですけど、駅前にあるビルがですね、今度壊されることになってしまって、ゲームの中ではお店が3つ、コンビニエンスストアと、ハンバーガーショップとカレーショップが入ってたんですけど、今もう秋葉原はもうそれは全部取り壊しの予定で、お店が全部なくなっちゃって、このタイミングでなくなるのは、まあ、びっくりしたなっていうところはちょっとありましたね。
Yeah, actually, while we were doing that for Akiba Strip, we did it in the summer, and what we didn't know is that in the following winter, the buildings that we took right next to the station were actually planned to be destroyed and rebuilt as new. So you have stuff in the game, like a convenience storethat does not exist anymore.
Yeah.
It has been replaced now.
With something like Akihabara that just completely changed is, and we, really a weekly basis. In a way, I think this is kind of like a way of keeping record, basically by making the Akiba series from Acquire as sort of an archive of what Akihabara looked like back in the time. So in a way, it's kind of like a historical relic.
A time capsule.
Yeah, it will be a time capsule.
あのこんなに街があの早く変わる、
うんうん、
あの秋葉原は、
はい、
あのもうこれこのゲームはまさにあのタイムカプセルっていうことになりますね。
そうですね、あのやはりその作っていた当時の街並みを、モチーフにしてますし、また、秋葉ズトリップの方も、その時の街並みです。ですので秋葉ズトリップの1それから2それから、秋葉ズビートっていうのを比べてもらうと、秋葉原がどんな風に変わってきたかっていうのをちょっと分かるかもしれませんね。
Yes, of course, it does keep a fixed point in history of Akihabara, and if you're interested in the city, you can just compare the three games.
Yeah,
and you will get a good idea of what has changed, what has movedwhat has stayed until the, over the years. So it's a very interesting part of the game that you can experience, you can make you experience the city of Akihabara.
Yeah, definitely. So I think we're back to the game right now. So we're going to see a little bit more in depth of what the abilities might look like and what other battles might be.
それではゲームに戻ってもよろしいですか？じゃあゲーム画面に戻ってもよろしいでしょうか？お願いします。So let's go back to the...to the game now that we are back again, and we will show more advanced levels. あの、
はい、
さっきからあの何度も横断歩道を撮ってたんですけど、
はい、
ボタンで押して撮ってるようあのですけど、
はい、
もしそのまま進んだら引かれるのでしょうか？
そうですね、引かれてしまいますのであくまでも左右を確認して OK ってボタンを押すことで渡ることができます。
なるほど。 I realized that They've been gently waiting at every crossing and pressing. There's a button prompt. You can see like O button to.
Hey, we don't want to endorse jaywalking to people who are visiting Akihabara.
And I was wondering, like, what if you just like started running through the streets? Yeah, you would definitely get hit by a car. So be careful. Check your left and right.
はい、さっきとダンジョンが変わって、今回はアイドルの妄想で生まれたダンジョンです。ですからアイドルのステージのように向こうで奥の方でサイリウムを振っているお客がいたりとか。
Oh, there's a crowd over there in the back as well.
ポップな感じですね。
As you can see, this dungeon is a little different from the one before. This one is born from the imagination of an idol. So the whole background, if you check it, you have like those glow sticks from the idol concerts.
Right.
And it's very colorful. It's very different atmosphere from last time.
So it is a complete reflection of the person's imagination. Yeah. Very nice.
今回はキャラクターが4人も登場
して4人います。また、彼の攻撃自身も非常にあの炎のエフェクトが出たりとかして、非常に強力なものになってます。
I was just looking at it because they're all up to like level 65 right now, so they're really pumped up.
Yeah, this is really the top level things. As you can see, there are more visual effects going on. He has like fire items, the hero has fire items on.
Yeah, so there's a base of elements in here as well, yeah.
はい、ちょっと開発の画面が出ちゃってますけど。
Sorry guys, you get to see a little bit of behind the scenes and a little...
I think that's kind of a freebie, which would be...
Yeah, yeah, that is something you don't see every day. That's bit of development tools here.
This is the actual development kit that we have right here.
Enjoy that. A little sneak peek into what it is to develop a video game.
Yeah, definitely.
But you can definitely understand if this is the end game, it's definitely still being made, so I would understand why we were having to do this.
もうちょっとで、ボスの面、はい、来ました。これがこのステージのボスですね。
And here comes the boss. Finally, we can show it to you.
朝日さん、いました。
それじゃ、や。
一名
様。All right, let's take a look at this.
すごいです。です
ね。
What? かなり。お
お。Oh, there's some elaborate moves over there. What does the actual headphone image look like?I see a headphone image on each character sometimes, so I wonder what's that.
ヘッドホンが現れてて、それはどういった意味なんですか？
ヘッドホンマークがつくことで、イマジンゲージというのが溜まったということを表した。いわゆる妄想の力みたいなものですね。それが溜まったときにイマジンモードを発動すると、より強力な攻撃をすることができるようになります。
So the headphone icon actually marks the fulfillment of your imagine gauge.Which is like the power of your imagination, and once it's full, you can unleash more effective and more powerful attacks.
Wow. So that indicates that your gauge is actually filling up right there. Sweet.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Look at that.
一緒にあのこのストリームを流しているあのインフルエンサーの方からあの、yeah. ちょうど今メモをこう届いて、
はい、
あの秋葉ストリップのおかげで私は秋葉原で迷子になったことがないのでありがとうございます。
それは良かった非常に。
That's where our good friend Daoshi TV is here as well, and we'll be actually talking to him in tomorrow's program as well. But he's just gave us a little note saying that he knows around Akihabara because of Oculus Trip.
Yep.Thanks to this game.
Yeah, so kudos to that TV.
Kudos to you, thank you, Brad.
Which is actually hosting this program as well on this channel.
Yeah, he is hosting.
さっき、アクションカウンターあったんです
。Oh, there we go.
ここ無限大になってるのはその攻撃無限です。今、必殺技を出しました。
So here comes one of the special...special moves
nice,
that we were talking before.
Nice.
As you can see, the counter we were talking about, the one that was going 4-3-2-1,
yeah,
is way higher now. And during the special move, it goes into infinite mode.
Yeah,
where
infinite
you can,
mode,
you can,
so you can just literally wail
You
on
can just pummel down those enemies super hard.
That's fantastic.
はい、設定するそれがメニューを使っていろいろこう、
はい、
あの例えばヒールをするあの回復するとか、はいはい、そういうのは
そうですね、それぞれ、AI といいますかそのキャラクターそれぞれに考え方を持たせることができて攻撃を優先させるだったり回復を優先させるアイテムを使うのか使わないとかっていった設定をすることができます。
じゃあチーム作戦をこう考えながらいろいろ設定するという
ね、はい、このさっきの必殺技
です。 Oh, and here's another special move.
Whoa, sweet.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah, I love the effects on it. There we go. Yeah.
So I was asking if you were controlling your allies or they were controlled by AI, and there's an AI with different settings. You can set priorities.
はい、もうすぐですね、先ほどイマジンゲージ5段階までたまると、
oh, wow.
より強力な、イマジンフィールドというものを達成します。ここですね。ヘッドホンをぜ
ひ。Wow, nice cutscene there.
So the imagined gauge, that is the pink gauge on the left corner, was going fuller and fuller. As you can see, it has like 5 steps, and once you get to the 5th step, you unleash kind of a fury mode.
We even get a change of background music.
Oh yeah, yeah, you have a change of music, background, and it gets into complete fury.
Absolutely fantastic.
背景など曲バックミュージックに合わせた、曲に合わせた、エフェクトがよりまでなまさにそのステージで歌を歌っているようなそういったのを楽しむことができ
ます。本当に音楽をテーマとしてビートを
ビートですね。はい。
素晴らしいです。Very
colorful.
Gin-chan was just saying that, but yes, the background is changing. The music gets darker tones, and the animations and the effects are synchronized to the beat of the music.And you can really feel the attention to the theme of music in this game.
That's fantastic. I really like the stylization here. Really cool colors going on. We got another super over here.
今度はこちらのカードことみというキャラクターの必殺技です。
This is the special move from the character called ことみ。
This absolutely is fantastic. I'm gonna have to ask you guys to cut it at this point. I'm sorry about that. I know you guys want to see a little more, but we are definitely running out of time, so if we can take a pause right here
かなりボスを倒しているところのを見たかったんですが、
はい、
残念ながらもう
時間が来てしまいました
なってしまったので
I'm so sorry about that. I really really am excited to see more
いうところで終わりにしていただければ、
はい、了解です。じゃあその実際にボスを倒すところは皆さんゲーム実際に、ね、プレイしてみて楽しんでください。
ネタバレをしてそれでもいいと思います。
はい、
So unfortunately we did actually hear that、there was a bit of a delay for this game just recently actually. So、can we maybe estimate that it's going to be sometime in 27 that we're going to get this?
そうですね、もちろんこんなにあのゲームの中を見てやりたくなってて、はい、あのゲームのリリースは、はい、実際いつ頃になるのでしょうか。
そうですね、国内は年内12月を予定しています。また海外の方、我々アクワイアではないですが、
あの
エクシードゲームさんの方から来年を予定しています。来年の早い時期、はい、
Q1 Q1 ですね、Quarter, First Quarter、
はい、
right.
予定してます。
Very well, thank you very much、yes, so、for the release in Japan, it will be definitely this year in December.
Right.
But right. We're
that's,
not...
That's fantastic.
Unfortunately, we're not doing... we're not experts at localizing, so we leave that to our friends at Xseed.
Oh, okay.
Who will do the English version that will, should be released in first quarter of 2017.
Oh, that's pretty
so
good, yeah.
Very soon.
Very soon.
The
well,
wait will not
wait
be too、
that.
Long.
Thank you very much. And thank you again for coming onto our stage and showing us Akibus B. It is a true treat to actually have to see the immersive gameplay here, and I cannot wait for the release. I'm going to have to get this as soon as it comes out. So thank you again. That was Acquire. And thank you very much for coming to Tokyo Otakumo Livestream House. Thank you again.
もう本当にあのこの1時間で秋葉原で旅したっていう気持ちがしてて非常にあの感動した体験だったので、
はい、ありがとうございます。あ
のまたダンジョンのところも非常に楽しくバトルをするのを、はい、あの期待しておりますので、はい、あのアクアイアの皆さん今日お越しになって本当に光栄で、あの誠にありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much everyone. A round of applause for Acquire.
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。 Thank you very much.
Alright
then, and that leaves us just one program left, so after a few minutes we're going to be changing into Capcom.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and we're going to have a little sneak peek of Resident Evil, so we'll、Ooh. Be right back, ladies and gentlemen. Give us a few more minutes、mm-hmm. and we'll be back with our last episode for today from Tokyo Game Show 2016.
See you guys in a few minutes. Bye bye.
Bye.